Hey guys, welcome to today's video. I'm going to be sharing with you guys 10 luxury and high-end items that are totally worth the splurge. We are going to go ahead and count down in no particular order all of the very bougie and expensive items that I have found over time to be totally worth the moolah. Please excuse my hands. Me and my husband did a little bit of a tie-dye project earlier this afternoon and decided not to put gloves on. So there we are. With that being said, let's just go ahead and jump right into it. So the first product that I want to give some love to is from Chanel. This is the Soleil Tan de Chanel. This is a cream bronzing product. Oh my goodness. This bronzer is gorgeous. That's all I can really say. Not only does it look absolutely beautiful on the skin, but it blends like a complete dream. It is so effortless and beautiful, easy to use. It is the perfect shade. And I always say that when it comes to a bronzer, in my opinion, what makes it awesome and what will make a bronzer absolutely perfect is if it's something that I can not only bronze with, but I can get away with contouring as well. It's one less step, and if I can knock out both of those with one product, then I am all about it. And this product does that beautifully. Again, from the blend to the shade to the longevity. Every time I wear this in a video and I'm going through and doing my editing, I just think, dang, my bronzer looks so on point. Obviously, I do have it on today. It is just the most beautiful tone ever. Now, this is an item from Hourglass. This I have talked about on my channel. And in fact, it was the first product from Hourglass that I ever got to try. I did get it in a Beautylish mystery box last year. I have their Veil Translucent Setting Powder. If you have dry skin, this is the answer to your prayers, especially if you have dry textured skin, if you have more mature skin. Oh my goodness. There is something about this product. It reflects light without actual glitter or chunks of shimmery reflex or anything. If you look very close to it, it does have a very finely milled reflect to it, but it is so fine and just so beautiful and soft and effortless. There really is no other powder quite like this. I have tried other luminizing powders before and they are beautiful, but this one just is very unique. Another nice thing about this is that it is free of talc, which I absolutely love. And I really enjoy the packaging. I have seen other people say they don't like this packaging, but I actually think it's really nice. It keeps the product in one place. It allows me to use the amount of product that I need instead of having a lot of waste and having a ton of it get stuck in the cap and just causing a mess. I can appreciate the packaging. It feels very luxury, very high end. This is one of those powders that I just can't recommend enough. It leaves you with the most beautiful, flawless finish. Now let's talk about a couple of products from NARS. The first one I want to mention is the Summer Lights Face Palette. Now, I did do a dedicated review on this palette last year. This was limited edition, but there are some places that you can still get this product, and that is why I am talking about it. Sad story, the other day I was looking at this and I dropped it on the floor and I was standing. So it fell about 5 feet. I was devastated, and sure enough, I opened it up and I broke the pans. But nonetheless, not in a whole bunch of little chunks. It is still very functional. This palette is just beautiful. The highlight in here is gorgeous. The bronzer in here is absolutely beautiful. These eyeshadow shades right here, what else do you really need? I love a face palette that you can actually utilize every single shade in it. I feel like more times than not, regardless of the price point, there are so many face palettes that you look at them and you're like, oh, it's beautiful overall, but I don't picture myself touching that shade, or that blush just really isn't my style, but the rest of it looks absolutely beautiful. I literally use every product in this face palette. The packaging is absolutely gorgeous. I love the mirror on the inside. It is just a true home run. You really can't go wrong with this guy. It can go with you everywhere. It will provide you with everything you need. It is simple, it is beautiful, and it just gives you that perfect bronzy look. Another item from NARS, that this is actually new, this launched this spring. This is their bronzing powder in the shade Paradise Found. First off, the packaging. Really, really so beautiful. Beautiful. I can't. It's stunning. Obviously, the packaging makes everything better, but It's the product inside that counts. This bronzer is gorgeous. Now, this is their Laguna bronzer, but they did add more of a sheen to it. It's got this gold overspray to it, and it gives you the most gorgeous glow. This bronzer is effortless. Now, I did mention in my review, I will put that in the description box below if you want to see a dedicated review to this product. I should mention, I did also do one on this as well. Any of the products that I'm talking about, if I have done thorough, dedicated reviews on them, I will link them in the description box below. This product does work very well with a natural hairbrush. I have tried it with a synthetic brush. It still looks beautiful. It blends beautifully, but there's just something about it. So if you are someone who does use natural hairbrushes, you are going to love this product. It is gorgeous. It smells just like an island paradise. It truly does do that to you. It takes you there. It is paradise found in a makeup compact. Absolutely gorgeous. Another one that I can't stop using. Now, this is probably the most over-the-top bougie product that I have ever owned. I think the most I have ever spent was $98 on a La Mer powder. Oh my goodness. And then I also bought a half ounce of their soft cream one time from La Mer. Now, both of those items were beautiful. Not enough to make me repurchase them. But again, this, I have to say, This is bougie. From Sicily, this is the Double Tinsoor. Now, I'm sure you guys have seen this around. Jaclyn Hill has used this. Tati has used it. Nikki Tutorials, I believe, is the one who really put this on the map. And this is one of those products that was just like, oh my gosh. What makes this product so incredible that you just hear so many people rant and rave about this? And finally, I just said, forget it. I'm going to treat myself. I really want to try this product. And you guys, I have to say, it does something magical to your makeup as a base. I don't know what it is. Your skin will just shine through and look absolutely flawless underneath your foundation. It doesn't even matter what foundation you use. I have tried this under a tinted moisturizer. I have tried this underneath my L'Oreal Freshwear foundation. I have tried it underneath my Dose of Colors foundation, which is my go-to right now. I have really tried this guy underneath several different types of products. And I don't know what it is. It is the work of magic. It just does something absolutely beautiful to your skin. And right now I keep looking in my mirror that I have in front of me because I just have this glow, something to my skin. It does something to your foundation and it definitely adds to the longevity. Obviously, it is a skincare product, so it is infused with a ton of skin-loving ingredients. It is supposed to plump and tighten and blur, and it does all of that. It is absolutely beautiful. I love it. It is one of my all-time favorite splurges. I do have to say that. From Tom Ford, I have the Flawless Glow Foundation. This does have a broad spectrum SPF 30. This was a product that I was actually expecting to hate, and I did plan on doing a dedicated review on it, but I never did for some reason. I don't know why. This launched last spring, summer, and when I finally used it, I was like, damn it. Why is this good? Like, I was like, why is it good? Because it is $88. And I was like, why does this have to be so good? This is one of my all-time favorite sheer foundations. It just gives you this like dewy glow to the skin that doesn't look heavy throughout the day. It doesn't break up. It doesn't look weird on the nose. I know a lot of people say they struggle with tinted moisturizers on the nose. It breaks up. It just looks weird and patchy. This one doesn't do that. There is just something about this product. It just works. That glowiness, that dewiness, and it just looks beautiful. It leaves your skin looking supple and absolutely stunning. And when you mix the two of these together, skin dreams, skin goals, it is absolutely fantastic. I do want to mention that when I was looking this up online recently, just to see if there was like a price change or anything, a ton of retailers have this on sale right now. So if you've been interested in trying this out, or you really want to get your hands on a Tom Ford product, if you want something that is lightweight, that gives you that dewy, fresh look, has an SPF in it, check, check, check. It meets all of your requirements, just like me. You will absolutely love this product. It really is that good. I absolutely love it. One more item from Hourglass. This is a product that did launch this year, I believe. This is their Vanish Concealer. Another product that I was surprised that I loved as much as I did. The amount of coverage that you get from this is actually insane. And it's not in a way where it's like you put on like a Tarte Shape Tape and you're like, whoa, everything is flat and gone and just completely diminished. It's like effortless. You put this on, first off, from the applicator, which I absolutely love. It feels like you're putting a literal pillow underneath your eyes. I'm not even kidding you. But it just, the way it swipes on, everything about this just feels like, oh, I'm just so fancy and effortlessly gorgeous and beautiful. It's just like, it's a whole thing. It's a whole experience. From the packaging to the formula to the way it looks on the under eyes, it's like velvety smooth and beautiful. Like I said, it's just a total experience. It is one of the best, hands down best concealers that I have ever used. It is in heavy rotation. Absolutely love it. And I do have to say that the undertone on this is spot on. Color-wise, this is probably the best shade of concealer for my skin tone. And I should mention the shade. It is in the shade Oat. There's just something about it. It is perfect. It is the absolute perfect shade for my skin. I feel like the concealer gods just dropped this right down from the heavens, right into my lap. And I was like, yes, please. Thank you. It's just so good. Another one that obviously I recommend checking out if you are in the market for that type of concealer. This is actually a skincare item from a brand called Is Clinical. This is their Copper Firming Mist. I have talked about this on my channel before. This has been a favorite of mine for a couple of years now. We're running up on 2 years. What is so fantastic about this is that you can actually prime your skin with this. It is infused with a ton of skin-loving oils that are non-comedogenic. It is refreshing. It has a natural citrus scent to it from the orange peel oil that is in this. This product is just everything. And like I said, not only does it prime for your makeup, it also sets your makeup down. This is one of those that I do like to mix with like an all-nighter or a Tarte Stay Spray, something like that, where I can get that beautiful hydration back to my skin, set down the powders, and then put down a setting spray that will actually add to the longevity. The morning of my wedding, this was part of my skincare routine after everything was on and I had my moisturizer on and everything. I actually had this in the fridge, whipped it out, and then sprayed it on the face to add a cooling effect just to kind of calm the skin. And it really did do a lot. So I love this. It's a multi-use product. It's refreshing. It smells fantastic. And it does amazing things for your skin. All right, so let's go ahead and move on to the lips and talk about what I have on today. Another product that I have talked about on my channel many times before. This is from Charlotte Tilbury. This is one of her hot lips in the shade Kim KW. This is such a classic Hollywood pinky nude. It is so gorgeous. Now, when I first put this on, I was like, that's a little pink. That's a little pink. But it was like, once it like settled into the lips and I had it on for a moment, I was just like, ooh, yes, that is absolutely gorgeous. This is the perfect nude pink shade. I have searched high and low for dupes for this. I have scoured the internet. I have looked everywhere, but there is nothing that is exactly like this. Either it's too pink, it's too peachy, it's too gray. There really isn't a dupe that I have found yet for this particular shade. It is gorgeous. Fantastic. One of my all-time favorite lipstick shades. Every single time I put this on, I'm like, yes, that is why I love this so much. Absolutely beautiful. And then something I tried not too long ago from YSL. This was actually the second product I have tried from YSL, I believe. This is their Rouge Volupt Rock and Shine lipsticks. These are actually more of like, I would say like a gloss lipstick hybrid. It gives you this beautiful glossy sheen to the lips. These two shades that I picked up are absolutely stunning. I have this one in the shade number 1 and then this one in the shade number 3. I can't remember what the exact names are. It was on the packaging, but they're not printed on the bottom. It just has the number. I believe the pink one is called Pink Flow. But either way, if you go on Sephora's website, it does say the number as well. So again, number 1, which is my favorite nude right now. Oh my goodness, I love this. In fact, I can put it on right on top of the Charlotte Tilbury Kim KW. Beautiful together. Absolutely stunning. And these wear beautifully on the lips. And obviously, again, it's one of those things. Can we talk about the packaging? Beautiful. It's just like I keep saying, a total experience. Beautiful packaging, so pretty to look at. I have these actually right behind me in my lipstick display right in front. And every time I'm editing over here and I've got my computer out, I just look over at them and I'm like, you are so darn pretty. Do you know, like, I wonder if they know how pretty they are. They're just so good formula-wise. They're comfortable. They wear beautifully. They don't get patchy or gross after you eat or as the day goes on. Easy to layer. Absolutely stunning. This one especially is an underrated product. I don't know why I haven't heard anybody talking about these. At least I haven't anyways, because they are perfection in every way, shape, or form. Leave me a comment down below and let me know if there are any high-end or luxury products that you absolutely love. Is there anything that is a total holy grail in your collection? Did you try something only to be completely surprised, either in a good way or a bad way? Also, let me know if there is a product that you have been dying to try that is in the luxury high-end realm of things that you would like to see me review. I would absolutely love to do that. Give this video a huge thumbs up if you liked it, share it, and of course, subscribe to my channel. Those three things alone help me so, so much. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.